الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أجمعين. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم، تب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. اللهم لا سهل إلا ما جعلته سهلا، وأنت تجعل الحزن إذا شئت سهلا. Inshallah ta'ala, in the next few minutes we will continue with the story of Rabi'a ibn Ka'b that we started off yesterday, because Rabi'a, when he was telling this story to his friends or to his students, he was trying to make a point. And that point was how sometimes different stages of social life brings about a change in the relationships between people. So Rabi'a told his students and his friends that his first stage of life was like that. He was a very poor man, staying with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam as a servant. And we all, you know, heard the story of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam telling him to get married, and Rabi'a saying, "I don't have anything." And finally the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam helping him through his problems. So Rabi'a continues, he says, "That is the first chapter of my life." He says, ثُمَّ جَاءَتِ الدُّنْيَا فَاخْتَلَفْنَا. He says, and then the dunya came to us. The dunya, the wealth. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made us wealthy. فَاخْتَلَفْنَا, and then we had bad relationships. We had arguments. We had fights about the dunya. He's talking about the Sahaba. He says, when we were poor, when we were struggling in life, everybody loved each other. No problems, no arguments, no fights. He says, but when the dunya came, when the wealth and the money came, اختلفنا. It created problems between us. And then he wants to give us an example of that. And subhanAllah, he's giving us an example of dunya creating problems between the highest of the Sahaba, the best of the best of the Sahaba. He says, ثُمَّ جَاءَتِ الدُّنْيَا فَاخْتَلَفْنَا. He says, as an example, me and Abu Bakr had an argument. Rabi'a is saying, I had an argument with Abu Bakr. And everybody knows who Abu Bakr is. He was the best after the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Rabi'a says, I had a garden of palm trees, and Abu Bakr had the garden that's next to me. So he said, one day there was this palm tree that was sitting right on the border of the two gardens. So I said, this is in my land. And Abu Bakr said, no, it's in my land. And he said, there was heated, you know, exchange between me and Abu Bakr, until Abu Bakr got angry and he insulted me. Insulted Rabi'a in a very harsh way. He's giving us example, you know, when dunya comes, sometimes it even affects the best of the best of the people. So this Abu Bakr talked to me in a very harsh way. He said very tough words to me. I'm quiet. He says, around me were some men from my tribe, Aslam. Remember the guys who helped him out when he was struggling, right? they are around and they see Abu Bakr insulting Rabi'ah. So Abu Bakr left. So these guys came to Rabi'ah and said, why don't you defend yourself? SubhanAllah, why are you so quiet? Abu Bakr is saying all these bad words to you and you're just quiet watching. Why are you so weak? Why don't you defend yourself? You know, this is human nature, right? Sometimes the two people could understand each other, but the third party always makes things worse, right? They say, what's wrong with you? Are you a fool? Why don't you defend yourself? Are you scared of him? You know, they started, you know, talking to him in a, trying to put him in a fight with Abu Bakr. But SubhanAllah, Rabi'ah knows who Abu Bakr is. And he decided to teach these guys a lesson. He looked at them and said, do you guys know the person that you're talking about? First, lower your voices so he won't hear you. Because wallahi, if he hears you talking to him about him like this, and he gets upset or he gets angry, for sure the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam will get angry, and Allah will get angry at the tribe of Aslam, and you will be destroyed. SubhanAllah, because he knows the position of Abu Bakr when it comes to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He said, ألا تعلمون من تتكلمون عنه هذا شيخ المسلمين وشيبة الإسلام. This is the Shaykh of the Muslims. This is the elder of the Muslims. You're talking to him about, not talking about him like that, trying to put me in a fight with him. Wallahi, if he says every bad word in this world to me, I will never reply a single word to him. So I'm recommending you that you go away so that Abu Bakr won't hear what you're saying about him. They were shocked. They were surprised. SubhanAllah, what's the lesson in this first part of this story? The lesson is, no matter you know how good the person is, when it comes to the issues of wealth and money and business, it always creates problems. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave us instructions in the Quran, and the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us clear commands in his sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that if we are partnering in a business, everything should be clear. It has to be written. It has to be written, and there have to be witnesses on every business deal that you are getting into. You know, when it comes to business, there is no uhuwatul Islam or anything. You know, oh, we're Muslim brothers and sisters, you know, we trust it. None of that works. Business is business. If it created problems between Abu Bakr and Rabi'ah, who is better than Abu Bakr and Rabi'ah? The Sahaba of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. That's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, even if you are taking a loan from someone, write it down. يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا إِذَا تَدَايَنْتُمْ بِدَيْنٍ إِلَىٰ أَجَلٍ مُسَمَّنْ فَاكْتُبُوهُ. Not only that, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, call witnesses so they can witness that this person is taking a loan from this person and he will retain it on a such and such date. SubhanAllah. Nowadays, if a Muslim comes to you and he asks you some money, oh, can you lend me $1,000? If you tell him, okay, let's write it down, he will get upset. Right? He will get very angry. And his first reply will be, so you think I am a thief? You think I will steal your money? And he will probably leave you, and he won't even take your money even if you give it to him. And this is the instruction of the Quran. This is the command of the Quran. Allah says, فَكْتُبُوهُ, write it down. وَلْيَكْتُبْ بَيْنَكُمْ كَاتِبٌ بِالْعَدْ. And actually a third party should write it for you as a witness. And Allah says, get two witnesses that are just people and reliable people. So in other words, in our world today, it has to go through either a lawyer or it has to be notarized, notary public. Any business deal that you're going into, it has to have a written document, it has to have, you know, witnesses and everything. So we won't ruin the relationships between Muslims. And subhanAllah, some Muslim brothers came to the masjid one day and they're having an argument about a business that they have together. It's a business in the millions of dollars. Think about it, millions of dollars. So they said, we put some money together and we made this business now, you know, somebody's denying, you know, that they had that money to us. So we asked them, did you guys write this? They said, no, they didn't have a single written document about this whole business. And it's in the millions of dollars. I asked them why. They said, because, you know, we trusted each other, we were good Muslims, mashallah. So he said, oh, mashallah, you trusted them for the sake of Allah? I said, yes. He said, now, forgive your money, inshallah, for the sake of Allah. It's lost. Because that's how it is. You give your money to him, trusted him for the sake of Allah, now you have to forgive him for the sake of Allah. Because you did not follow the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, now you are telling me that you trusted him for the sake of Allah. So that's the first part. When it comes to dunya, it creates problems. It ruins the relationship between a father and his son, a mother and her son. So we have to follow the commands of the deen so we won't fall into these problems. The second lesson is, we have to know the respect that our elders have upon us.
That's it.
You know, the oldest people among us have a respect. So we have to put them in their position and we have to know their respect. The Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّ مِنْ إِجْلَالِ اللَّهِ إِجْلَالَ دِشَّيْبَةِ الْمُسْلِمِ. It's part of respecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when it comes to respecting the Muslim who has gray hair. إِجْلَالَ دِشَّيْبَةِ الْمُسْلِمِ. To respect the Muslim with the gray hair is part of respecting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So this is what Rabi'a understood very well. His reply to his tribesmen was, هذا شيبة المسلمين. This is the elder of the Muslims that you are talking about like that, trying to incite fight, you know, between me and him. He said, even if he says all the bad words in the world to me, I will not reply. And this is how we need to act as young people. Sometimes when our elders, our mothers, our fathers, our uncles, our aunts, when they are talking to us in a harsh way, sometimes we have to look down and we don't have to reply. This is part of the respect that we need to fulfill as Muslims. So Rabi'a, you know, Abu Bakr of course felt bad when he said whatever he said to Rabi'a, and he left crying to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he was crying. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked him, what happened? He said, oh Prophet of Allah, there was some argument between me and Rabi'a and I made a mistake. I said, you know, something bad to him. Now I don't know what to do. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, you know, wait here. And after a while, Rabi'a came to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam and he saw Abu Bakr feeling very bad, you know, broken down, crying. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked Rabi'a, he said, Rabi'a, what happened between you and Abu Bakr? So Rabi'a said the same thing. Oh, the Prophet, there was a little argument about a tree, a palm tree. And then Abu Bakr got angry and he said something to me and I think the problem was from me. Subhanallah. Look at the adab and the akhlaq of both of them. Before that, we have to look at the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. He asked Abu Bakr, and when Rabi'ah came, he also asked him what happened. This is the way we need to deal. If two parties have argument, we have to ask both of them. You know, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam trusted Abu Bakr like none, you know, in this world. He trusted him to the maximum. But still, when it comes to, you know, relationships of the people, you have to ask all parties. So Abu Bakr was feeling that he made a mistake. Rabi'ah was feeling that he is the one who made the mistake. And this is the adab we need to have. SubhanAllah, nowadays, if two people have an argument, both of them will swear by Allah that they are right and the other party is wrong. Right? But the Sahaba, it happened that they had an argument. It's okay, it's human nature. But both of them were feeling that they're the ones who made the mistake. This is the adab we need to have. This is the higher moral ground that we need to be upon as Muslims. If an argument comes, you have to always blame yourself first before you blame anybody else. But if you are always Mr. Right that never makes mistakes, then we won't go anywhere. And SubhanAllah, if the two people are feeling that they are both right, it's always almost impossible to solve that argument or that problem. Because each party is insisting that they are right and the other person is wrong. But look at the Sahaba. Abu Bakr said, I made a mistake. Rabi'ah said, no, I think I started it. I made Abu Bakr angry, and that's why he said what he said to me. So I am the one who needs to apologize. And Abu Bakr said, no, I am the one who needs to apologize. And they started going back and forth in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Abu Bakr insisted that you, Rabi'ah, I said this and this and this to you. Now you have to say it back to me in front of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And Rabi'ah said, no, I am the one who made you say that, so you need to ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to forgive me that I started this fight with you. And they started going back and forth. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is looking. So finally he said, you know, both of you make dua for each other, and this should be the end of it, and go about your business. SubhanAllah, this is the way we need to deal with each other. Even at times when we have arguments, we need to hold up our moral ethics as Muslims, and we shouldn't be selfish that always, you know, claims I'm right, this other person is wrong, and we need to follow these lessons of the Sahaba. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdika, ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.